Hey everyone, this is Jason Burke, CEO of High Performance Summit. Today I want to talk about the article yesterday I shared out on Tempest Cities to Invest in 2021. And I know there's a lot of great cities on there, Boston, North Carolina, Tampa, Florida. But what I want to really talk about today is really more of what criteria you should look at when you decide to invest outside your local market. And one of the things, a couple of things you want to look at is one, you want to look at you want to reach out to the economic development office. You want to see what incentives they have for incentivizing companies to move jobs there. You want to see what companies are moving there in the next couple of years and creating jobs, what sectors are strong, what unemployment base is, what the economy runs on, what the income, the average income in the certain areas that you're going to invest in. You want to see, is the job growth coming down the pike? Is there a path of progress that you can find out about that you can get in front of or just behind that can be really good? You want to develop some local relationships with like a good mortgage broker, a good realtor on your team, good attorneys in the market, especially you're developing a power team specifically in certain markets. You want to have good people on the ground that can give you real honest advice about the situation, about that, and you want to do your own due diligence, because if you go into our state market, you want to have your team, your property management, everything set up you need to. So when you invest or you hold, buy and hold, or if you're doing a fix and flip, whatever real estate strategy you have, you know what the cycle of that market is, because every market is different in real estate. And some cycles may be, you may be in a buyer's market, you may be in a seller's market, but you really want to get to know the market, the average prices, the average price of home sell, how fast the homes are selling for, what areas, you can find distressed, motivated, flexible sellers is another thing. You want to find some good wholesalers in the market, find some people that can be on the ground and develop some relationships. So you want to take a look at a couple of things. You want to take a look at the economic development office. You want to find out what incentives are for business to move, what businesses are moving in there, what job creation is going to happen in there. You want to see where the unemployment, where the employment numbers are going. They're going up, they're going down. You want to find out what the median income is in that market. What are people making? How is real estate doing in certain cities? Are there places where you can find value add opportunities that the city has strong local leadership? And that's another thing. Does the city or state have strong local leadership? Because that could be all the difference in the world between the market being good and a good investment for you to place your dollars in somewhere not being so great. Because there's a lot of great cities and they have a lot of great metrics, but you have to do the research out front work in that market. You need to develop your power team to be able to take advantage of the opportunities that exist in somewhere like a Boston or a Tampa or North Carolina or some of the cities that you see on the top 10 cities to invest, like Nashville. Because you know the market, you know what your exit strategies, and always have three exit strategies as well in any market. Because you don't, if your number one exit strategy is to fix and flip, figure out if you need to wholesale that property or you need to buy and hold property. Always have three strategies that you can exit out of any deal. So if your first or second strategy doesn't work, you have a third strategy and backup plan. Because anything's about sitting down and building that plan. But doing the research up front and talking to people on the ground and interviewing people for your power team and getting that up and running is going to be crucial to success, especially investing out of state where you can't just drive to the properties that are in the state. So you need that team on the ground, whether that be your property manager, be a realtor, be a contractors, be a title or escrow people. You need to develop that in place. And the best way to do that is ask for referrals. Find people in your network that know people they can connect you with and refer them. That's always the best way you can get introductions to referrals and professionals that in that market. So no matter what real estate market you invested in 2021, if you have a good power team, you know the market, you know the economics, you know if there's going to be job growth and incentives. Now things to watch for. If you don't see the cities have any job incentives or the slashing incentives for business to move to the city, that's a case of stay away from that market because they're not incentivizing growth and have a growth plan. You want to clearly see that they do. So just to recap on the 10 best cities to invest out, when looking to invest in an out-of-state market that's not in your local market, reach out to the economic development office in that city, find out what they have going on, what incentives they have going on, what tax incentives they have, how they incentivize the companies to move, what companies are moving there, with what, how many jobs they're creating over the next few years. What are the best, what are the citizens, what industries dominate that market? What is it, a diverse economy, or is it like an economy that depends on one industry, like Nevada is heavily dependent on hospitality and tourism, whereas somewhere like Boston has more diversity as far as education, finance, healthcare. Those are things you need to know, the average income of the print, are the people making the market that you want to buy in. What are the rents going for? What are the high, low, medium rents going for? How fast are the houses moving or the buildings moving in the sector that you want to invest in? What are the rules and regulations to say? These are some of the things to consider when investing out of state. But if you put us, and the most important thing is to put a solid plan together with a solid power team around you in that market. So that will increase your chances of successful. That was my review on the 10 best cities, just giving you some tips on how steps to take forward and how to evaluate markets, especially if you're going to invest out of city. This is Jason Burke, CEO, High Performance Summit, going 0 to 60. Have a great